presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. Get our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take him by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't take anything personally. Your truth is personal to you. Your own opinions and point of view reflect your own agreements and are personal to you. It's no one's truth but your own. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 96, NASDAQ is up 24, S&P is up 23, gold contract flat, 18.13 an ounce. Silver up 24 cents, $19.77 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 75 cents, $41.04 a barrel. We had a big drawdown in the crude numbers today, folks. Notes and bonds. 10-year note down 2 ticks, 139.11. The 30-year off 18 ticks at 179.23. They both rejected lower price out here. They continue to want higher price, lower yield. King dollar. King dollar down 164 ticks, trading 96.096. King dollar is trying to save itself, folks. It was down like 400, but coming back. Bottom line is coming back at a crucial place. We'll see whether it can basically save itself and get to higher price. Euro. Euro is at 114. The yen is out here at 106.95. And the British pound is at 125 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, let's take a look at the futures. We've been banging around 10, 15 points all day long. We're up 24 bucks right now. Bottom line, we'll see whether it wants to attack the lows of the today out here, which were established at noon. That number there is the 3192. And the X100 is basically screaming in this market that it wants lower price. It rode us all the way up, folks. Now the bottom line is that you had 2 days of weak NDX 100. We'll see how this baby shakes out. I do expect as we're coming into the close, it's going to go after this. It's a high volume low that's laying out here from this morning, also at noon, 10,551. So what we had here is it's quite a spread. No doubt about that. Bottom line is that, we're down off the highs about 120 points off the highs inside of the NDX 100. We take a look at the gold contract. Gold contract still wants to bust higher. Bottom line, you're get a flat market out here today. We want to see more contract volume in the gold market. We started off really strong. You're only at 176,000 contracts. It's not bad, it's not great. That's the real bottom line. What you need out here is that I want to see 200 basically each and every day. Yesterday, we got the 253. Prior day, you got the 230. Right now, you just 176. You want to see more if, in fact, you're a bull in that metals market. Silver, bottom line, silver catching the bid once again. Silver is basically almost leading this baby up, which is pretty cool. Silver is 1977. Silver is going after its 21 swing point, folks. And the silver equities are following it right along into higher price. Notes and bonds. We take a look at this note and bond market. These are just the ever-ready bunny, like in an incredible way. The 10-year note was down at 139.03 today. Bottom line, rejected lower price. You're at 139.11. As did the 30-year bond. 30-year bond was down a full point and three ticks, 179.03. Bottom line is that that rejected that, so you still get sideways movement. In both cases, folks, it looks to me that they are actually going to bust topside, which is pretty wild because you still have, let's see, so the 10-year right now, but points, yeah, we're 0.62 of 1% in the 10-year. And notes and bonds want to bust topside. And so it's going to be wild watching, like, what percentage rate are we going to go down to? King dollar. Let's go over to King dollar and take a look at King dollar. This has been a one-way route on the way down. King dollar had a big day out here today. Went after the lowest swing point. Now, this is what you have with King dollar. If you're a bull, it would have been on the dollar. It would have been better if it actually hit the swing point. We didn't hit the swing. The swing point in King dollar, we're talking about the 10th of June. That number is 95.716. Well, we got to 95.777. And we did reject lower price. That being said, you're not getting inside a higher range. You'd have to get all the way back up to 96.385, and you're not even close to that. So what we very well may get here is may get a few days of sideways movement going sideways. If that's what you get, what you'll see is that it'll run after that lowest swing point again, and we'll see whether it's taken out. My short-term take inside the dollar, folks, is that the dollar wants to go to 94. In a few months, I expect the dollar is going to be at 88. And I'll show you the 88. The 88 sets up, folks, I believe it's the 2018 swing low. And if you break this level, meaning the level that of the 94 level, it's just sticking out there like a sore thumb. Yeah, it's December of 2018. The dollar, no doubt, in March had saved itself. It got all the way down to the 94.610. That's what it's going after right now. Bottom line, there's not much there's nothing in between that and getting into that 88 area. So we will see how that whole baby does shake out. We take a look at some of the higher volume equities inside this marketplace out here today. What you're going to see is that you have all the dead cat bounces that are actually bouncing. We got Expedia right now is up 9.4%. That's up $7.69. You got Marriott up 8%. You got Trip.com up 7.2%. And you got Ulta Salon up 6.8%. And this is where the NASDAQ 100 has a problem, folks. I've talked many times about how the chips bring the NASDAQ 100 up, bring the composite up. They drag the S&P up. You're looking out here today, guess what? It's the chip stocks. You got ASML down 5.5%. You got Clack off 2.8%. Bottom line, those are big numbers. Taiwan Semi, they are going to be coming out with numbers. Let's see, what day is today? They're coming out with numbers tomorrow. So we'll see where that shakes out. Taiwan Semi, of course, largest manufacturer of chips in the world. You know, that's going to tell us quite a bit about going forward, how many more orders that they actually do have coming inside the marketplace. Dow Industrials, what the Dow has also done, folks, is this. The Dow was up over 400 points. The Dow is weak in a monster way. It got into the lows of the high of where we gapped down, and it couldn't handle it. We got to 27,071. You're at 26,739. Bottom line, any close between under 26,938, total failure in price as well as volume. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now about 126. We get the NASDAQ up 30. S&Ps are up 25. And let's go take a look at a couple equities for a couple tigers out here. You got Progressive Corporation. That's a big insurance company, of course. The low is $62. The high is $86. And let's see. They're going to be coming out with their numbers tomorrow. Yeah. I don't know. Is today the 15th? Yeah, today's the 15th. So they're going to be looking, let's see, they're going to be looking at 10.2. Let me just look at this again. Yeah, after the close. Yeah, they're coming out today after the close. Okay, so let's take a look at this baby. I see. And that is a break top side, no doubt. And this is a break top side with volume. Yeah, they got action, man. Holy cow. And these insurance companies, folks, they're making money hand over fist. The rates are going up dramatically. You know, we're talking about the tune to 23 to 33%. So you can picture why, bottom line is that you have a couple insurance companies taking over each other. And for what is happening out here, I expect what you're going to see. You're going to see, bottom line, the numbers they're expecting. Let's see what they're expecting out here. So they're expecting 10.2 to the top line and $1.34 to the bottom line. And if you want to see, this is pretty wild when you actually look at this, that you look at the aspect of how they're growing. Picture a commercial. So this is hard to comprehend, actually, that an insurance company can grow like this. Personal lines are growing by 16%. Commercial lines are growing by 22%. Property is growing by 21%. And business is growing by 23%. That's just a monster, man. That is really a monster. The bottom line is that, yes, you got a breakout, and you have an equity that looks to me like it does want to go a lot higher. And then fundamentally, depending which state you're in Florida, those numbers I gave you, those are numbers that are in Florida, and they're going up, and they're going up pretty dramatically. In most states, folks, first you have to go to the regulator. But the bottom line is that they already went to our regulator, and they're in bed with them. Let's go take a look at State Street. State Street right now is trading $64.29. And let's see, is this coming out with numbers too? They're going to come out with numbers at 7:30 in the morning on Friday. So the low is 42, the high is 85. State Street's the monster clearinghouse and back office for the large broker-dealers. We go take a look at this. Okay, so let me put this on a weekly. Well, I'd be careful on State Street here. I mean, yeah, I'd be definitely careful because you had the pop on State Street to that 74. That was the week of June 5th, and then they just gave it up and went sideways. So that's saying that there's not a lot of strength in that equity. Of course, Goldman came out with numbers this morning. Numbers on Goldman were just a monster, folks, okay? Bottom line is that as traders, okay, you can see how they can basically pull this off. Because what you have here is this, okay? You have the where do you see these numbers, first off? Okay, so these numbers, when I put these up, they $13.3 billion they took in 90 days. You can see the rest of these numbers. That dwarfs all these numbers except when? Except the first quarter of 2018. Now, what do we have the first quarter of 2018? Guess what? You had a little volatility in the marketplace. Goldman thrives on volatility as traders thrive on volatility. Now, that's the first part. The second part is actually even larger in this particular case because what you also had is that inside of those numbers, folks, the amount of money they made in the bond market was exponential. And what we did have is that when March came and the downdraft came in, within, I think it was like 3 to 5 days, the Federal Reserve had come in as the savior for the bond market, period. So what ends up happening in the bond market, it's totally non-transparent. It's not like when you're dealing with corporate bonds, folks, the bottom line is that as we are looking at spreads out here, you can see them every day. Corporate bond market, that's not how it goes. You can get an idea of it, but it's non-transparent in a huge way. A trader like Goldman, they know where all the bonds are. They've already pushed out the amount of bonds to many of these companies. They know where they can sell them. So when they're buying and selling them, that's how you see that astronomical numbers in the billions, okay, that go out there. That's how this baby shakes out. That's how they can print so much money. When you actually look at Goldman, now this is what's really intriguing here. When I'm looking at Goldman, you know, it made a high today of 225. You're at 216. And this is one of these deals that you went up with volume and really didn't hold price. Well, when you go up with volume, folks, the bottom line is that you go right back topside. So my take, Goldman is going to go up there. Now watch this, though. This is what's also going on with Goldman. It almost looks like Goldman can make it up to this 250 area. And if that's what you got, the high is a 270, but the 250 looks like game to me. So the 250 was right before we came down on the downdraft. Now that would make sense if, in fact, the bottom line is that we continue to get more volatility inside of the marketplace. Okay, that's how this baby can go exponential once again, because what you see out here is that people should have understood that volatility is a trader's best friend. Well, the bottom line, you can see what happened with JP Morgan as well as Goldman, okay, made money hand over fist. And the way that is set up right now, it looks to me that this volatility will continue and they will get up to that 250 mark. We're going to take a look at Expedia out here today. You have the travel stocks, you have the hotel stocks. They caught a bid out here today. And that was my point when I started the program off that, you know, inside the NDX 100, when you have the dead cats that are the ones that are moving it and the NDX 100 can't even hold price, that's a problem. That being said, what you have is this. We had a huge sign of strength coming off lows in May. We topped out on June 5th to June 8th inside of the airlines as well as the hotel companies. Expedia, you know, you're up $7.70. You have a swing high of 97, and that's game. That's the bottom line. That's game. You're going to see it in every one of these equities. We go take a look at Marriott. You're going to take a look at Marriott out here. Now they died in the vine once they went there. Marriott had that swing high as $18. I mean, 118. You know, you're at 93. And can it be game? Yeah, it can get tested. That being said, what you want to wrap your head around is that at those levels, the equities themselves never took out a swing point. So when you don't take out a swing point and you do have signs of strength, The bottom line is that, yeah, you can test them, but you don't have to get by them. That's an American airline says one of the biggest ones out here, meaning further away. American just got slammed. American had the sign of strength, went to $22 and then came all the way back down to 10. Now, as it did it, came back to the breakout area, you know, there's no sellers there. Bottom line, you know, it caught a bid once again. 877-927-6648. We have the Dow Industrials right now up 122. NASDAQ is up 27. S&Ps are up 24. Stay right there, folks. Come back with our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. We are going to be talking markets.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hinks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes up the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 178. We have the NASDAQ up 55. S&Ps are up 32. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Wednesday at 30 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Basil does an outstanding show here every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, The Opening Call. Now, it's very easy to get The Opening Call, folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN. See it right under Featured Content. You just hit the middle button, Opening Call. You hit Subscribe. You can get Basil's newsletter for 1 month for $128. You can get it for 6 months for $5.95, which is a savings of $173, or 22%. You can get it for a year for $9.95, which is a savings of $541, or 35%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, folks. Everything to win, zero to lose. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Very good. Thank you.
I heard you're getting some heat in Boston, right?
Actually, it's been very cool, but I think the heat is coming in.
Oh, really?
From today.
Cool, man. Cool.
Yeah, it was a lot cooler than usual this time in July, the last couple of days, but it'll be here.
That's humidity. Nice, man. That's nice. So,
yeah, as long as
market-wise, what do we got here?
So, this is going to be an interesting week because last week was a special week. I said that this is the week that we will get the test of how the NASDAQ either completes its run to the upside and then takes a digestive phase. What happens if, in fact, there is a digestive phase as they've had spectacular gains, you know, the Apples and Amazons, etc. What happens if they start to digest the gains? Where will the money go? And that's really what, for my subscribers, I'm trying to find right now. In fact, we try and start positions now in some of the cyclical stocks that have been out of favor. So I thought it would be an appropriate time just to go through some of the techniques we're looking at because they've been applying to, you know, we've had some really good gains this quarter. And I wanted to say that some of the techniques that we've discussed, I talk about in my show, the Tiger Technician's Hour at noon, and we go through these things. So I thought I'd just go through a couple of things right now. So basically what we look at is try to identify the lowest low bar and count each successively higher peak. I alphabetize them. It can go to seven higher peaks. It's alphabetized A, B, C, D, E, F, G in sequence. It's at that fourth highest peak that other things can happen. You can see the way I've drawn it here. And then there's another couple of techniques. I'm always looking for, let me just get out of that. I'm always looking for either a straight line up or a straight line down. A cup formation, that could be a V, but it's basically a cup formation going from one point down and then back to that point. And what happens when you get back to that point, or it's the other way around, you come down and then you rally sharp and you come back to the same point. What happens when you hit that? You spoke about the dollar. We've seen the dollar keeps making low lows recently. So it's been taking out that left side low. And then there's a combination where I call it the lowercase h or the reverse y. If in the h pattern you take out the left side low, you can go lower. On the right side, if you take out that left side high, you can go high, and that's why it's green. And another pattern that I talk about quite often is it's a rising trend line that keeps getting bumped. It's not a matter of how many peaks, but usually when you get to peak D, E, or F, there's a pullback, and then you start to make lower highs and lower lows, and it looks like an expanding cone, declining cone. And it all of a sudden stops, and it starts to go up. And my big thing is, over the many years that I've been doing this, it's how it breaks that downtrend line. Can it go one-to-one? I call it a Chapman wave one-to-one parallel move, because you can go in the same direction, the same angle, a one-to-one expansion. So with that said, let me show you what we're looking at here. In the Dow, we went to a peak D. That's what we were talking about, that fourth highest peak at 27,580 on the 8th of June. And not only that, we came down very sharply. We had 2 days red, and then the third day there was this huge decline. I think that was about June the 8th. And then what happened, that's called an island reversal. So that island reversal is quite potent because if it doesn't get closed almost immediately, that can hang there as a lot of resistance. So we came down to 24,843. And we've been fortunate. We got, talking about lows, trying to identify the low. We did identify the 23rd of March low. We had bought calls. We still have calls that are going to roll over into the next month. So they were bought at 10.5, and they're really much higher than in the 60s right now. But most important is that we also got the diamonds at 210, and they are trading right now at about 268, I think, 267. So this is very important because then you start the pattern with a bounce, and it comes down, and it makes the pattern that I call the H pattern, that red one that we showed, but this time it didn't take out the low. So it bounced and made a successful test of the H. Then that H can very often go to a lowercase M pattern as the second arch forms, and that's the clue, because if that one breaks under key important support levels, in this case, the 200 period moving average, which I think in the last month and a half has hit about 15 times. So that's how important these moving averages can be. If it holds that, then all of a sudden this pattern can morph from a potential negative pattern to a cup formation. So one of the things that I look at is the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence. On the left here is the daily, in the middle is the weekly, on the right is the monthly. And look, the MACD was going down, 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 and yet it did not break that low. and that was around about the 27th or so of June. Instead, it ran up, and then, of course, yesterday was a very strong session, and today it gapped up, and we filled. Now we filled the gap, and we did that very quickly with the QQQs. You saw that very. You saw just the other day with the S&P, the Dow's been lagging. In fact, the IWM, which is trying to play catch up, hasn't yet filled those gaps. It hasn't even taken out the left side high. So this is a pattern that we'll look at right now, is that cup formation. So far, that's very strong. The MACD finally turned positive. That's a good thing. And the stochastic isn't at 80% or higher. That's what I like. It's at 77. So it's got some catching up to do. But I think that the Dow is trying to test the last high of the 8th of June, the 27,580s. Here's that pattern that I call the falling axe. Look, here's this. I call this the Chapman wave, inside wave. So inside track repellent zone, this the green and pink dashed lines, and we are right at the top of that line. We haven't broken it yet, and we've seen, I've shown a number of times, both in the den and in my show. I wonder if I've still got this here. The ESU just, yes, the ESU did that. See, there's this declining falling axe, lower lows, and much lower, lower highs, much lower lows. And then we expanded in a parallel motion right to, we went a little above the extension. So this is pink and that's green, just to show how it breaks out. Once you can take out that trend line and you've started in the S&P, this is the E-mini contract, you've started to take out that resistance. So to me, I still see upside action. I like what I see. I think we're looking at rotation, and that rotation is so important, because if we didn't get the rotation, we'd be seeing a lot lower prices very soon. So I think there's still enough strength to see the Qs, NDX 100, take a breather. The S&P is acting quite well. The Dow is playing catch-up. The IWM, which has been the most horrible laggard, is just starting to pick up right now. It is in leg D, but this is very good action. So I think there's a rotation. That's one of the reasons I say to subscribers, we're going to try to get into some of the laggards, like cyclicals here, to add to our list the stocks that we have, and most of them have done really well. So I think this is going to be good. We'll see what happens. Because, as you were saying, this is a fascinating period. We've got a lot of crosswinds, but I think so far things are looking pretty good.
And folks, it's very easy to get the newsletter. Just come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content. The opening call, just hit subscribe. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Basil, you have a great one, a safe one. And of course, we look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Don.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow's up 233. Nasdaq's up 66. S&P's are up 35. Right back, folks.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live, and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Bio biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We have the Dow. Dow's up 216. Nasdaq's up 60. S&Ps are up 34. Let's go take a look at a couple equities for a couple of tigers out here in the YouTube den. Bloom Energy. So Bloom Energy, folks, let's see. They manufacture power generation equipment. Company offers on-site power generation systems utilizing fuel cell technology to generate electricity. So the low is $2.44. The high is $18.25. Revenue out here, when you take a look at them, they take in $171 million and they lose money, 26 cents a share. That being said, bottom line, you get this thing up $4.85 today, monster move. And that being said, the bottom line is that what this is looking to do, let me put it back in 3 years this way. So what you have, and if you want to see, like, you know, we're always talking about how volume pushes highs or lows. Bottom line, you can see this quite clearly when you even go back to July. We went from a price point of 771 to 1106, 34 million shares. Last swing point out there had 22. Now you just blew away this whole swing point. So what you have here is this. Let's see. So you just blew away the consolidation from December of 2018. And what that does, that's, you know, that's saying that you do have game on. Let me put it on, that's 4 year weekly. I put in a 5 year monthly. Yeah, yeah, there's game on here like the $26, man. You know, 26 is the, I'm going for the low of the high. The high out there is 38, but it certainly, it has the volume in it, it has everything in it. So, you know, the question is the tiger got in it at about $5. And the real question is, you're up 481. Always a sweet way to do something like this. Let me see, what is the news on this thing today? Let's see what they got. Okay, so Bloom Energy soared the most in more than 3 months after the fuel cell maker announced plans to jump into the hydrogen market. The San Jose company plans to start selling electrolyzers machines that generate hydrogen from water next year, according to the statement Wednesday. When powered by electricity from solar or wind facilities, devices can create the fuel without greenhouse gas emissions. Currently, most hydrogen is produced from natural gas. Nate, the bottom line, I'm sure you know something about the equity, but you got a wild one there. There's no doubt about it. You know, the real, yeah. I mean, I would basically, many times, you know, when you get a score like this, is that yeah, you can take half of it off or get your principal back. In this particular case, you don't have to sell one third of your shares to get your principal back, and then you just let that thing ride for years and see where it goes. What happens when you do something like that, folks? Okay, is that you basically have got your principal back, and even when you get deep retracements, if in fact they have breaking technology, I mean hydrogen technology that doesn't come from gas, so guess what? It can go up pretty dramatically. So 877-927-6648. Go take a look at the Amazon. So Amazon, this is, you know, the Amazon just came across and said that their employees are going to be can stay home until 2021, January of 2021. Amazon's letting most corporate employees work from home until January and will continue restricting business travel. And see, just looking at that right there, folks, okay, the bottom line, how Amazon, market cap-wise, okay, we know how big it is, okay? It's a monster. Staying home is one thing, but you see the restriction of business travel? Companies, folks, are going to get used to the aspect of getting done many things that people would go on the plane for before. And I think that is going to take a long time to get back to a face-to-face deal. Everyone wants it. I'm not saying they don't want it. I'm not saying that we will not get there, because we will. We'll definitely get there. I mean, all the technology is great. There's no doubt about that. But there's nothing like having big shows. You're presenting at shows or you're going to shows, okay? We've done hundreds of them, okay, throughout the years. You know, I don't expect that to go away. But that being said, I don't expect that to go back in for a good year and a half or 2 years, maybe longer, you know, bottom line. So that no doubt will affect hotels and it affects airlines in a dramatic way. No two ways about that. Let's go take a look at the XAU, the HUI inside the gold market. That's continued to basically hang tough. You get the XAU right now. That's up $1, 138.03. And the Gold Bugs Index out here, that's flat. Trading 312.52. And both of them have already broken out of their consolidation, folks. And what they do have, they get steady volume, and they're staying on top of their breakout area, GDXJ. If we take a look at the small caps, the small miners, rather, inside of the gold market, they also, now they really broke out. It's kind of intriguing, okay? From the February 20 highs, that was 46. They're 53. When we put this on a longer basis, I see what's happening here. 52, yeah, no, I see what's going on. Okay, so this gets really interesting. What's also happening here is that they're going to actually need more juice. Well, that's on the monthly. Let's see, we're on the 15th. Yeah, they're going to need a little more juice. Staying over 52.50 is a big deal. We want to see them get more juice. Let's go to John in St. Pete. Hey, John, what's going on?
Hey, how's it going, Tom?
It's going great, man. Yourself?
Doing really well, thanks.
Good. So, we're looking at Gene, huh?
Yeah, Gene.
What a rocket ship this is. Let's take a look at it. Now, they were trading this in the Tiger's Den, folks, okay, out here this morning. The low's 140, the high's 1030. This is trading 612 right now. Now, do you own this? Are you looking to buy it? What are we doing here?
Yeah, what I was looking to do is, it's funny you were just mentioning about putting in your investment and then removing your principal. I do that frequently.
Yes.
And this is kind of one of those things I was looking at doing that, but I'm looking for an entry point here. And because it's acting the way it is, it just kind of went up so fast and so hard, I'm not quite sure what a good entry point would be.
Yeah, don't buy it right now because we already hit 10:30. It's getting smoked right now as we're talking. Right, it was up $5 when you called. It's up $3.47 right now, so you're at $5.70. Okay, so this is going to be. So, what happened here, folks, is this: the stock today went from $2.64 to 10:30. When you get something like this, John, right? This is like, I suspect it's going to be a complete implosion, and it's going to be 2, 3, 4 months before you can buy this stock. Because what will end, here, let me pull this back. Let me just, yeah, it is. Because this is the ultimate on how many people are going to be trapped. So what you have is this. You get 365 million shares that were traded today. You went from $2.64 up to 10:30, and there's going to be so many people that are trapped like rats up there, John, that it's sick. So this will take, it'll take months, you know. And your buy on this is $2.46. Not, yeah, so.
Figured that.
Wild, man. Thanks for calling with it, though. That's a wild one, man. Holy cow.
Yeah.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 209. NASDAQ is up 48. S&Ps are up 31. And, you know, the type of market that we're in, folks, when you take a look at gene tech, this is the type of market that we're actually in. And that being said, it's a very dangerous market, okay? When you get equities that can go up this dramatically and then go south and trap lots of traders in those equities, that little by little, this is what you do see at highs. The last time I would say that we saw this as dramatically inside the biotech area, you are going back to that almost 2000 level. And then on top of that, of course, and I meant Dave White was just saying to me, the pumping and dumping. There's no doubt. The pumping and dumping is out here. And, of course, we have the Barstool Dave and the Barstool Dave types inside of the marketplace. Because if you remember, if you were around in the 90s, there's going to be a lot more than just one Barstool Dave. There'll be, most times you're going to get 5, 6, 7 people that can—they can run markets, man. That's the bottom line. There's no doubt about it. This gets so unique, in the aspect that you have Robin Track. That's a cool thing. If you haven't looked at it yet, folks, you definitely want to look at it because it does tell you just about in real time where all these Robinhood traders are going. Because the bottom line is that I would say that they are the ones that are running the market. And it doesn't mean that they can't run the market forever. I mean, I don't think they will. But the bottom line is that you want to pay attention to it because they, you know, when I first started the market, even when I was on the, I always said, you know, Fidelity is really cool. They hide themselves like always investment. They were the biggest day traders, and they still are because their accounts are so big. That this has just turned into a heavier trading deal, and as we keep going forward, it's going to keep going heavier and heavier. The reason being, folks, is that there's no commissions inside the equity markets. There's no commissions inside the option markets. It totally makes sense. It's like, guess what? People want to be entertained. They want to trade the markets, man. That's the bottom line. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it. Take ownership of it and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Come back and visit us tomorrow morning. Tommy kicks us off 8:30 in the morning. Great show. Yeah, look at him.